So, chapter two, day has arrived, which I've been really looking forward to all week. In fact, when I wake up at night for a wee, and I normally go back to bed and fall straight asleep, I've been so excited thinking about today, I couldn't get back to sleep again. That's how exciting it is. Anyway, I wanted to make a few key notes after last time, because the last time I talked about what happened was 7 hours after. But the next day and the following few days, what I did notice was that my problem solving and my attention was heightened, without a doubt. I don't know all those little things that normally I wouldn't bother do. So that's quite an important point to make, I think. And that my, you know, my senses were really tuned in from that day on, and I felt like it's not a party drug, we all know that, or people that don't know, it's not a party drug. You don't come up, you don't have a high, you don't go down. Your spiritual innards kind of raise, and it stays raised. And I've read, after I experienced this as well, is that is what happens. So that's fantastic. I just feel a little bit more elevated in life. There's no graininess to the feeling of a microdose. This was less than 1 gram, about 3/4 gram. Of dried, but the other thing was, a couple of days before I took it, when I was thinking about it, I had a lovely dream about that I took it, and it was a wonderful experience, so I took that as a good omen. And also since then, I've heard, I think it's the Amanita Dreamer lady, she mentioned that as well, so that's a good omen. And I am quite shamanistic in my ways these days, as you'll soon find out. So my skill set has been more so. It's like I've had an injection of, I don't know what the word is. Maybe I need to find that word today. Anyway, today I'm going to, what I've decided to do, because I went out on the day after to look for another mushroom. And out of all the places I always go in the countryside, I haven't seen another one since last year. But this image of one came to me, and I drove straight there, and within 5 minutes, I found one. And it was a young one. It's the size of, it's sort of, I think I'll show you a picture later on. It's dried now. It was a young one. It's a bit bigger than the first one I took. And it's been in the airing cupboard for 1 week. And it's now weighs, it was 23 grams. This is just in the airing cupboard. It's now 2.15. And somebody mentioned that it would lose about that much moisture, and it has. So I'm going to consume the other half of this, because I know that was safe. And I'm going to cut off about the same amount of this new one. 0.65, so it's just underneath. So basically, those two bits, 1.40. So it's almost 1.5 grams. So I pretty much doubled the dosage. This one still smells a bit weird, like old pants. But it doesn't bother me, you know. So I'm going to eat this one. I may as well eat the Stipe as well, so I feel like I'm with Michael Stipe today, because I like Michael Stipe. I don't think there's anything in that, but I eat it anyway. By the way, a friend Rachel gave this to me, so I feel like today Michael Stipe and Rachel are coming with me. Not that bad, just a bit like cardboard, really. I mean, it's not crisp and dry like the proper way of drying it in the machine, but so that's half, and then this new half, here we go. Oh, it's a bit dry and crispier. Not really much flavour, but it's not horrible. Bit weird. Fuck. Oh, fuck, shit. I can see why people make nice tea out of it now. I tell you, that's something I'll get round to doing as well, but I just wanted to start nice and basic. This is just for newbies, it's just an experiment. I've read as much as I can read. And also, what's really interesting is that I've watched some programs on the Christian history of this mushroom, and there are lots of images, pictures of Jesus Christ in churches and all around the world, and depicted with this mushroom. So back in the day, they obviously used this mushroom, the Christians, to reach divinity as well as the shamans and everything else. So we'll go on to that further down the line. Now I'm off to the woods for a wonderful day, hopefully, and I'll check back in with you later. Over and out.
That's when Wendell G takes a tug upon the string and held the line of trees behind the house he lived in. He was reared to give respect, but somewhere down the line he chose to whistle as the wind. Tree had lost its middle, so he built a trunk of chicken wire to try to hold it up. But the wire turned to lizard skin and he climbed inside. It wasn't even time to say.
So that little caper was chapter 2, and I must say that overall not a great deal of difference from the first microdose. Just a little bit more spacey, a little bit more sort of heavy in the background. Vision was just, you know, nice and sparkly, a bit tuned in, a little bit woo, a little bit wah, but generally not nothing sort of massive, but still a great wonderful day. Had a good laugh, which I would do with or without anything. And so I went and found back in the same place a larger one so I can up the dose next week. Also found some which apparently are blushers, someone told me, so I'm interested to know about them. What everyone knows about blushers, can I take them, are they stronger? Apparently they've got no ISO in them, but have they got muscimol in them? Don't know anything yet, so I'm going to dry them out. And that's on another post if anyone sees. I'm interested to know about them. So I'll dry the next little monkey out, and I will try it next week. And yeah, happy days. It's good fun. I'll be seeing you.